Hello, I'm going to do part three of Dansk Poem A2. So I'm going to do the part three. And in the part three, it is like, I think it's the same as in A1. It's a picture. You have to listen to the dialogue or listen to what it says and then see if it's if it match in the picture that you will see. Okay, we'll check it. Let's start.
Delprøve 3. 6 forskellige dialoger. Du skal nu høre 6 forskellige dialoger. Du.
Part 3. There will be 6 dialogues.
Hør hver dialog 2 gange.
You will hear.
Du skal svare på, hvilket billede der passer til dialogen.
You will hear the dialogue twice, and then you have to answer which dialogue matches the picture.
Svar efter tonen.
Answer after the tone.
Dialog nummer 1.
Dialogue number 1.
Undskyld, må jeg godt spørge om noget?
Ja, hvad drejer det sig om?
Vi er jo allerede en time forsinket.
Undskyld, må jeg spørge dig om noget? Sorry, can I ask you something? Vi er en time forsinket. We are 1 hour late.
Ved du, hvornår vi er fremme i Aarhus?
Ja.
Hvornår, vil du, hvornår vi vil fremme i Aarhus? Do you know when we're going to arrive in Aarhus?
Vi skulle ankomme klokken 20:15.
Tak skal.
Vi skulle ankomme klokken 20:15. We should arrive 8:15. 20:15 or 8:15. Tak skal du have. Thank you. So we'll listen to the Danish dialogue.
Undskyld, må jeg godt spørge om noget?
Ja, hvad drejer det sig om?
Vi er jo allerede en time forsinket. Ved du, hvornår vi er fremme i Aarhus?
Ja, vi skulle ankomme klokken 20:15.
Tak skal du have.
Hvilket billede passer til teksten? A, B eller C?
Which picture match the dialogue? I would say it's the sea, right? Because it looks like a passenger and then a, yeah. Yes, if we look at the A picture, if we look at the A picture, it shows like, it looks like a clinic or something. And B looks like a public place, you know, it looks like in the middle of the city or something. C, I think it looks more like it's much because C looks like it's inside a train. So I would say C because, you know, it's like dialogue between the two.
Dialog nummer 2.
So let's listen to dialogue number 1. Number 2. So dialogue number 2.
Kroner, men de er slået ind til 40 kroner stykket.
Må jeg lige se din bog? Ja, det kan jeg godt se. Må jeg låne en flaske?
Ja, værsgo.
Nå, det er en fejl. I dag får man 20 kroner i rabat per flaske. Dit tilbud er fra sidste uge. Det er så ikke blevet rettet, men selvfølgelig får du dem for 70 kroner.
Okay, tak. Men jeg synes altså, I skulle tjekke jeres tilbud bedre, for der er tit fejl. Lyt igen. Undskyld,
listen.
Men det er altså ikke rigtigt, hvad du har...
Må jeg lige se din bog? Ja, det kan.
He said, sorry, I think I saw in the sale sign, this is a tilbud for, let's listen again. What did he say?
Jeg kan godt se. Må jeg låne en flat?
Undskyld, men det er altså ikke rigtigt, hvad du har slået ind. Der stod, at man kunne få 3 flasker for 70 kroner. Men...
He said, sorry, but I think you type in the wrong amount. It says that you could get 3 bottles for 70 kroner, for 70 crowns.
I slået ind til 40 kroner stykket.
Må jeg lige se din bog?
And then she typed 40 for each. And then the lady said, the cashier said, "Can må jeg se din bong? Can I see your receipt?"
Ja, det kan jeg godt se. Må jeg låne en flaske?
Ja.
And then she said, yeah, I could see that. Can I borrow the bottle? Må jeg se den flaske?
Værsgo.
Nå, det er en fejl.
Værsgo means, there you go. And then she said, yeah, det er en fejl. Yeah, it's wrong.
I dag får man 20 kroner i rabat per flaske. Dit tilbud er fra sidste uge. Det er så ikke blevet rettet, men selvfølgelig...
So it says that there's a mistake because we had a sale 20 krona per bottle last week, but it wasn't, they didn't correct it.
Får du dem for 70 kroner?
Okay, tak.
But you will get it for 70 crowns anyway, she said.
Men jeg synes altså, I skulle tjekke jeres tilbud bedre for dig.
He said... Men jeg synes, jeg skulle tjekke jeres tilbud bedre. But I think you should check your sales better.
Tit fejl.
Because der er tit fejl. There's a common always, like, it always happen. There always mistake.
Lyt igen.
Ja.
Undskyld, men det er altså ikke rigtigt, hvad du har slået ind. Der stod, at man kunne få 3 flasker for 70 kroner, men de er slået ind til 40 kroner stykket.
Må jeg lige se din bog? Ja, det kan jeg godt se. Må jeg låne en flaske?
Ja, værsgo.
Nå, det er en fejl. I dag får man 20 kroner i rabat per flaske. Dit tilbud er fra sidste uge. Det er så ikke blevet rettet, men selvfølgelig får du dem for 70 kroner.
Okay, tak. Men jeg synes altså, I skulle tjekke jeres tilbud bedre, for der er tit fejl. Hvilket billede passer til teksten? A, B eller C?
Which picture match the dialogue? A, as we could see, it's like a cashier and then the guy with the bottle. So it must be that one, because we're talking about this guy complaining about the price and you're talking about the receipt and the match that the price doesn't match. Second one looks like a conversation between a bus driver and a passenger. And C is looks like a fruit vendor or something. Fruit vendor and the one is buying the fruit. Yeah, looks like a yes. So A is the answer. Let's go with the next one. At least you would hear it twice. I don't know if you could pause it like I could do here, but I don't think you can. So just be
number 3.
Write it down.
Godt nok hårdt. Puh, jeg sveder.
Men godt.
Det er godt nok hårdt. It is hard. Men det er godt sveder. I'm sweating.
Hvad? Ikke? Du har da tabt dig meget, har du ikke?
Jo, det har jeg faktisk. Men...
Du har tabt dig meget. You have lost a lot.
Det er altså også fordi, jeg spiser meget mere grønt end før. Og så spiser jeg heller ikke så meget brød og kager mere.
That's because I eat more green and bread, and I don't eat much cake anymore.
Hvor har det jo mig. Jeg træner og træner, men jeg synes ikke rigtigt, det hjælper.
I train and I train, but I don't think it helps, the guy said.
Men det er jo nok, fordi jeg spiser forkert.
It must be because I eat wrong.
Lyt igen.
Listen again.
Det er godt nok hårdt. Puh, jeg sveder.
Men godt, ikke? Du har da tabt dig meget, har du ikke?
Jo, det har jeg faktisk. Men det er altså også fordi, jeg spiser meget mere grønt end før. Og så spiser jeg heller ikke så meget brød og kager mere.
Hvor har det jo mig. Jeg træner og træner, men jeg synes ikke rigtigt, det hjælper. Men det er jo nok fordi, jeg spiser forkert. Hvilket billede passer til teksten? A, B eller C?
Which picture do you think matches the dialogue? It's about two people talking about... They're exercising, obviously. So A is picture of look like a family. Looks like this is in kindergarten. And B looks like a office setup. And then C looks like it's in the gym where the female and the male are talking about, you know, how about their weight. So C is the right one. Let's go to the next one. We'll just do like listen to it first and then I'll try to translate afterwards. Sorry, I have to stop it because I have to like translate it at the same time so it would remember it.
Dialog nummer 4.
Number 4 dialogue.
Hvad skulle det være?
Jeg vil gerne have to røde, men kun et brød til.
Så gerne. Skal du have noget til?
Ja tak. Jeg vil gerne have en vand.
Det bliver 49 kroner. Lyt igen. Hvad skulle det være?
Jeg vil gerne...
Second time now. Hvad skal det være? What do you want?
Jeg vil have to røde, men kun et brød til.
Så gerne. Skal du have noget til?
Ja.
She said two red and a bread.
Tak. Jeg vil gerne have en vand.
Det bliver.
I also want the water.
49 kroner.
It would be 49 crowns.
Hvilket billede passer til teksten? A, B eller C?
Which picture matches the dialogue? Looks like the girl is buying a hot dog. Yeah. So as you could see, picture A is like a street, maybe asking for direction on the street. B is a is it? Yes, it's the B one. It's the B because it's she said about two red and then bread and then the water. So she's buying, you know, the pølsevogn in Denmark. You know those hot dog. You call those, yeah. Anyway, it's very common in Denmark, this pølsevogn, where they sell hot dogs and breads and ketchup and yeah. C1 is like looks like an information desk, and then the guy is asking for information. So I think if as long as you understand some of the sentence, you don't need to totally understand the whole dialogue, but if you get what they're talking about and you understand a little bit of it, then you could kind of guess which one it is. If you understand, okay, that's red, okay, it's two red hot dog, and then bowl is bread, so could kind of guess. So let's go to the next one. Dialogue number 5.
Nå, hvordan er det gået i dag?
Jamen, det er gået rigtig godt. Han har haft en god dag, tror jeg.
Har han sovet til middag?
Ja, han har sovet en hel time.
Okay. Nå, men vi ses i morgen. Lyt igen. Nå, hvordan er det gået i dag?
Nå, how... Nå, it's like an expression, Danish expression. It's like... or like... Well... How is it today?
Jamen, det er gået rigtig godt.
Det går rigtig godt. It went well.
Han har haft en god dag, tror jeg.
He had a good day, tror jeg. He had a good day, I think.
Har han sovet til middag?
Ja.
Have he slept this afternoon? Ja, yeah? Yes.
Han har sovet en hel time.
Han har sovet en hel time. He slept 1 hour.
Okay.
Okay.
Nå, men vi ses i morgen.
Nå. That expression again. No. It's like, see you again tomorrow. This is Simone. So, yeah. Let's play.
Hvilket billede passer til teksten?
Which picture matched the dialogue? Okay. I think the A one looks like the A looks like a waiter and then the customer. B looks like more of like, as I said earlier, kindergarten. Looks like a parent picking up his kid, and then that's the pedago, you know, those kindergarten. The one who's taking care of those kindergarten. So it must be this B picture. C is in the market, yeah, cashier, and then so it matches more in B, because you know it's about a parent asking about, oh, how was it today, and then is the kid slept for 1 hour. Normally in kindergarten here, if they're like small and they're the 3 years old, they have like those afternoon nap. So must be picture B. Let's go to the next one, and the last one, I think. It's another long video.
Dialog nummer 6.
Dialog number 6, and the last one.
Det var godt, I havde en tid nu. Det gør rigtig ondt.
Det er ked af at høre, men det varer ikke så længe. Så kan du komme til.
Okay, jeg sætter mig og venter.
Jeg kalder på dig, når du skal ind.
Lyt igen. Det var godt, I havde en tid nu. Det gør rigtig ondt.
Det er ked af at høre, men det...
He said, det var godt, jeg har en til nu. It's good I have a time now. Det gør rigtig ondt. It really hurts.
Bare ikke så længe. Så kan du...
Bare ikke så længe means it's not so long.
Kom til.
Okay, jeg sætter mig og venter.
It's not so long. And then he said, okay, I will just wait and sit.
Jeg kalder på dig, når du skal ind.
Yeah, I'll call you when you have to go in.
Hvilket billede passer til teksten?
Which picture?
A, B eller C?
Match the dialogue. A, B or C? We'll see. It's a bit blurred, but it looks like it's the A one, right? The A looks like did not maximize it. Anyway, the A looks like looks like this is a waiting area. It looks like, you know, when you go visit a doctor, you have to go to reception first and say, okay, I arrived, and then you have to wait in the waiting area, and then the reception or the one who's sitting in the reception desk will tell you, okay, if they call your name, then that's your turn. And then this one B is like it's a restaurant setting. So yeah. And then C looks like you're already lying in the bed there. Looks like it's already in the hospital setting. So no, there's no waiting area, so it doesn't match. So I think it's the A one. So that's your DanskPo A2 part 3 test. It's a dialogue. You have to listen carefully, write keywords that you know, that you understand, and then base it on the picture. For example, like earlier I said, red, two red and bread. Okay, what's that? That sounds like food. It's red hot dog and then the bread. And then here is like a waiting area. You know, you have to like kind of have a knowledge of different Danish words to pass this test. So good luck to all of you. I hope you guys pass it. Bye for now.